Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
They are also your family is wishing the IEC family a very Merry Christmas.
Hi, IEC family. It's Justin.
And Sharabo.
And we just want to wish you and your families a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas!
And may God's richest blessing be upon you and your families.
Merry Christmas!
Welcome, and we're so glad to have you join us here for our IEC Christmas presentation. Well, this has been a very interesting year. We've had our ups and downs. Things have been very difficult for many of us. And we're so glad that you can join us today as we encourage you with the words of Christ and what happened and that special Christmas over 2,000 years ago. Yes, things are different this year. Things are stripped back. We've had our shutdowns and things are different, to say the least. We pray that in your homes or wherever you are in the world today, we're here to encourage you. And on behalf of the entire IEC staff, people, our presentation is for you and to encourage you. God richly bless you.
Christmas at IEC is a special time. The kids come home from school for Christmas vacation. Our friends and family come home from abroad. And there's so many things going on at the church. It's decorated so beautifully with trees and ribbons and all kinds of splendor. And then there's the children's Christmas presentation and the choir. And we also have the Taste of Christmas, where everyone gets together and we have a smorgasbord of food from different cultures. And there's so much to eat. But the most special time of all is our Christmas play. You have to come early to get a good seat. And this is my seat, 6 rows from the back on the right-hand side, a little toward the middle. It's just the perfect spot so I can see. But the most important thing is this is a time where we remember the birth of Christ. And the Bible says, in Luke 1:78, verse 9, because of God's tender mercy, the morning light from heaven is about to break upon us, to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide us to the path of peace, perfect peace.
Thank you.
unto us a son was given. Rejoice this Christmas day. A gift from God to you and I. The truth, the light, the way.
To the world a Savior is born. Rejoice this Christmas day. He fills the soul, hunger, pain, the bread of life, the way.
To every heart bound in sin, rejoice this Christmas day. The gift of grace will set you free. To Christ the Lord, the way.
To thirsty souls everywhere, rejoice this Christmas day. Drink from the fountain of life, the grace, the mercy, and the way.
All those who are heavy laden, rejoice this Christmas day.
For he is the Prince of our peace, the door, the Lamb, the way.
Over 2,000 years ago, after announcing to shepherds that a Savior was born, angels joined in a chorus of glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. God was saying it was His goodwill to send a Savior bringing peace to the earth. The angels' words have been repeated at Christmas ever since. Why? Because there should be peace, at least at Christmas. Shouldn't there? So where is peace? Were the angels wrong, or is the peace that God promised different than the one that we're expecting? In John 14, 27, Jesus says, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you, not as the world gives. Do not let your heart be troubled, and do not be afraid."
Sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a village in Galilee, to a virgin named Mary. She was engaged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of King David. Gabriel appeared to her and said, "Greetings, favored woman. The Lord is with you."
Confused and disturbed, Mary tried to think what the angel could mean. "Do not be afraid, Mary," the angel told her, "for you have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus.
And he will be very great, and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Israel forever. His kingdom will never end."
Mary asked the angel, "But how can this happen? I'm a virgin." The angel replied, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the baby to be born will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God."
"What's more, your relative Elizabeth has become pregnant in her old age. People used to say she was barren, but she has conceived a son and is now in her sixth month. For nothing is impossible with God."
Nothing is impossible with God.
Luke chapter 1, verse 38 says, "Mary responded, 'I am the Lord's servant. May everything you have said about me come true.'" As a mother of two in a COVID situation, I'm still working. I'm working full time, and my boys, they are going to school and daycare full time. And for me, having that responsibility, ensuring that, you know, there's peace in the home, it's really of importance. And I've been really intentional in terms of giving them encouragement to go about their days. We've been fortunate to be able to share bite-sized blessings by Reverend Pastor Marva. She's been able to equip us parents to speak life into our children. And so each and every morning, my husband and I were intentional, and we've been speaking scriptures over our boys. And one that has stood out is perfect peace. And my youngest son, going back into the program after the lockdown, it was really difficult for him. Lots of anxiety, and he was just not managing. And my husband and I, were very intentional, and we would constantly bless him with perfect peace. And praise God, he's now happy to go back to class, and he runs into his classroom. And so just giving God praise for the Word of God that we're able to speak to ourselves, but also to our families in their home. And so may God's perfect peace be with you all.
A few days later, Mary hurried to the hill country of Judea, to the town where Zechariah lived. She entered the house and she greeted Elizabeth. At the sound of Mary's greeting, Elizabeth's child leaped within her, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit.
Elizabeth gave a glad cry and exclaimed to Mary, "God has blessed you above all women, and your child is blessed. Why am I so honored that the mother of my Lord should visit me? When I heard your greeting, the baby in my womb jumped for joy. You are blessed because you believed that the Lord would do what he said."
Mary responded, "Oh, how my soul praises the Lord. How my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior.
For he took notice of his lowly servant girl. And from now on, all generations will call me blessed.
For the Mighty One is holy, and he has done great things for me. He has shown mercy from generations to generations to all who fear him. His mighty arm has done tremendous things. He has shattered the proud and the haughty ones.
He has brought down princes from their thrones and exalted the humble. He has filled the hungry with good and sent the rich away with empty hands."
He's helped his servant Israel and remembered to be merciful. For he's made a promise to our ancestors, to Abraham, to his children forever. Holy is his name.
The kind of peace the world imagines is one without any turmoil or any conflict. And when the Christmas story is heard every year, everyone thinks of one glorious night where all is calm and all is bright, and of living in a place where everything is warm and fuzzy. But is this really peace? True peace is based on the foundation of God Himself. True peace is not dependent upon circumstances. In Hebrew, the word peace is shalom, and it means more than just having rest in your mind and heart. It includes a completeness or a wholeness. This peace is the assurance that you are in right standing with God. The announcement by the angels that Jesus was born meant that one had come to bring restoration. He came to bring that P-I-E-C-E peace that had been missing for so long. When humankind sinned, peace with God was lost, and shame and guilt was the baggage that we dragged around wherever we went. But this child born in Bethlehem came down in love to make us whole again. That gnawing feeling that something is wrong and we can't fix it now can be put away. And we can know that when storms come and evil seems to prevail, we're not abandoned and there's a way out. There's healing, forgiveness, and restoration that has come.
Everything inside me cries for order. Everything inside me wants to hide. Is this shadow an angel or a warrior? If God is pleased with me, why am I so terrified? Someone tell me I'm only dreaming. Somehow help me see with heaven's eyes. And before my head agrees, my heart is on its knees. Holy is He, blessed am I. Somehow I believe that you
Joseph, Mary's fiancé, was a good man and did not want to disgrace her publicly, so he decided to break the engagement quietly. As he considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, "Joseph, son of David," the angel said, "do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins."
And all of this happened so that the Lord's promise through his prophet would be fulfilled. "Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She will give birth to a baby boy, and she will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us."
God said he will keep in perfect peace those whose minds are steadfast because they trust in him. And we know that in all things, God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Perfect peace comes not from the absence of bad circumstances, but the reassuring presence of God despite the circumstances. Mary, the mother of Jesus, physically, she may not have experienced perfect peace. She was pregnant. So physically, she was not comfortable through all the three stages of her pregnancy. Socially, Mary had to deal with others who would not accept or understand the truth about her pregnancy. Social media of the day may not have been peaceful for her. Relationally, she had to share the miraculous circumstances with Joseph. That was not perfectly peaceful. Politically, the entire country had to return to a certain place to be registered. And let's not talk about Joseph and his feelings through this stormy time. Today, if you are suffering physically, socially, relationally, or concerned about the political climate of today, let Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace, rule your heart and mind. And that begins with experiencing the Prince of Peace.
And because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He traveled there from the village of Nazareth in Galilee. He took with him Mary, his fiancée, who was now obviously pregnant. And while they were there, the time came for her baby to be born.
She gave birth to her first child, a son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no lodging available for them.
That night, there were shepherds in a field nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, the angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified. But he said, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news, which will bring great joy to all people."
The Savior. Yes, the Messiah. The Lord has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David. And you'll recognize him by this sign. You'll find a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth, lying in a manger.
Suddenly, the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased."
The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the wind.
new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh hear the angels' voices, oh night divine, oh night when Christ was born, oh night divine, oh night, oh night
As children, when we fell down and hurt ourselves, we would run home to our mom, and she would kiss the hurt away. And she would assure us that it would be okay. And we believed it. Or when we did something wrong, and we felt the weight of guilt on her soul, and reluctantly would run to her and confess, we knew that in spite of that discipline that we'd eventually receive, that all would really be okay. Why? Because we were loved. And at a deeper level, that's what God has done for all of us. We can have peace because He loves us and He's taken care of our deepest need. But we have to do our part. We have to choose to run to Him, confess our sins, and give Him our burdens and our hurts, and know He's got it and everything will be okay. He's with us. He has overcome the world through His death and His resurrection. Peace is not a dream. It can be ours. Jesus said in John 16:33, in me, you will have peace. That is the promise. He is our missing P-I-E-C-E, peace. Take hold of him and have peace, not only at Christmas, but always.
When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." They hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there was the baby lying in the manger.
And it was about this time that three wise men from the eastern lands came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We have seen his star as it rose, and have come to worship him."
King Herod was deeply disturbed when he heard this, as was everyone in Jerusalem. He called a meeting of his leading priests and teachers of religious law, and asked, "Where is the Messiah supposed to be born?"
"In Bethlehem, in Judea," they said, "for this is what the prophet wrote. And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not least among the cities of Judah. For a ruler will come from you who will be the shepherd of my people Israel."
Then Herod called for a private meeting with the wise men, and he learned from them the time when the star first appeared.
Then he told them, "Go back to Bethlehem and carefully search for the child. And when you find them, come back so that I can worship him too."
After this interview, the wise men went their way, and the star they had seen in the east guided them to Bethlehem. It went ahead of them and stopped over the place where the child was.
When they saw the star, they were filled with joy. They entered the house and saw the child with his mother, Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasure chest and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child.
All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished, but Mary kept all these things in her heart and thought about them often. The shepherds went back to their flocks, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was just as the angel had told them.
God has been so good. He's been so amazing, giving us this opportunity to still worship him the way that we always do, but just on a different platform. IEC, we are so blessed. And even though we are not all here in these pews and hugging each other and smiling at each other, I know that you are at home. And it gives me great joy to know that we can still praise him together, that we can still worship him together. So this Christmas is still perfect because he provided us with a perfect gift, perfect peace.
Lord, you are my song when I don't have a melody. Lord, you are my strength when life's troubles make me weak. I just want to take my time and say, you alone are worthy of my praise.
Holy One, Christ alone, great I am.
Unchanging, you remain the same. Eternal, words cannot explain. So I'll sing. Take my time and say, changing, you remain the same. Ooh, eternal, words cannot explain. So I'll sing, ooh, so I'll sing. It's because of your love that I am not consumed.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning.
In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind.
The true light that gives light to everyone came into this world.
He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him.
Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name,
he gave the right to become children of God.
An opportunity for peace.
Those of us who were outcasts now invited in.
And those who were enemies were made families.
Those who were orphans are made sons.
Those who had nothing were made heirs.
Heirs with Christ, co-heir with the Savior.
It all began when God himself came down to us.
When God took on flesh and dwelt with us.
All hail the incarnate deity, the deity in the form as us.
And so we stand here at Christmas time to worship God.
Because the King took on flesh and became lowly.
So that we who are broken can become holy.
So that we who are alone could be wholly known.
Known by God, and so that we can know him.
And so, come to him, all who are broken.
Who are lost.
Who are alone.
Who are orphans.
Come to him and hear him whisper to you a new name.
Hear him welcome you into his family.
Hear him invite you into his family. As God himself says, you are my child.
And only I can give you perfect peace.
Now go and tell the world.
On earth and mercy on God and
Spectacular, wasn't it? Truly amazing. And I am so pleased with all the work that went into this and the end result, which was fantastic. I want to thank everyone who participated in this, planned this out, wrote it, coordinated everything so that everything fit into perfection, spot by spot by spot. It really was tremendous. Thank you so very much. And I want to thank all of you too for coming to watch this. I know that you've been blessed by it, and I pray that you too will remember all the things that you have heard in this production that will resonate within you every single day, all the way up to that special day when truly we celebrate the birth of our Prince of Peace. I thank you so much, and I'm glad that you were with us. Please make sure that you come back and be with us for the next three Sundays. I also hope that you come at our Christmas Eve candlelight service and, of course, our New Year's Eve service, which I'm sure will be absolutely tremendous. God bless you so. Thank you for being with us.